Hi, today I want to show you how to do a front row braid. This is when the braid goes in front of your head right here. And this is just a hairstyle technique versus like a hairstyle necessarily. You can do a lot of different things with this look. Like you can wear your hair down or in a ponytail, in the bun. You can even braid the rest of your hair again. So this is just a technique that I want to teach you how to do because, like I said, a lot can come from this. This is like the sixth time I'm filming this video, and I hope this is the time that I can be okay with and I can post this finally, because I'm actually excited to share this tutorial and slash trick. But every time I go to sit down and film it, Destiny's like, this is not gonna happen, Yana, not for you, not today, not this video. So cross your fingers. I'm gonna cross my fingers so this is gonna work out. All right, so what you'll need for a tutorial is you'll need a pin tail comb. Or, well, you can use your fingers, but you need something that you can part your hair with. This is actually a really cool little tool. I guess I don't know if I would call it a tool. I mean, it is a tool. Tool sounds really pretentious. This is like a hair comb, so go figures. But this is really helpful for parting your hair. Something with a sharp, but not too sharp, so you don't cut yourself. Point is perfect. Also, you'll need a bobby pin or something to secure your braid with. And then you'll need something to pull the rest of your hair back. I suggest using a hair elastic, but you can use anything you like a clip or anything like that. All right, so to begin our front row braid, I'm gonna take the pin tail comb. I'm gonna look down and I'm gonna take about 1.5 inch section of my hair. So starting from about here, and then just draw a line down, kind of like behind my ear. So like this is the part that I'm gonna use for the braid. Now I'm gonna take the rest of my hair and I'm actually gonna brush it back so I know that the rest of the hair is not meant to be used for the braid, and I'm not gonna mix it with this part because the way the hair is laying is like totally different, so I know it's a different section. I'm gonna put it in the ponytail. This is the final look, you guys. This is, you can go out like this. No, I'm kidding. This is the section you'll be working with. Before you commit to this section, what you can do is you can double check to make sure it's the right section for you. So the way you do that is you just twist your hair like so, and then you pin it back. Doesn't have to be perfect or anything like that, just, you know, perfect enough so you can see what's going on with your hair. And this is where the braid's gonna sit. So if you like that, which I do, I think this is a perfectly good location. My cat's trying to get in, that scared me. Whew. So if you like where your twist is positioned, then that's fine. You can go ahead and work with this section, but if you don't, then take another section and work with that. So I like the way my twist is looking, so I think the braid's gonna turn out good as well. So take your pintail comb and take a 1/2 inch section and then divide that into 3 sections and then braid each section once. Now this is going to be a really small braid because you have really small sections, but that's okay. So what you want to do next is you want to take another 1/2 inch section, and then you're going to want to divide that section into 2 and add the frontmost section to the frontmost part of the strands, and then the backmost section to the backmost strand of the braid. So let me go ahead and show you. So there goes one part. And I just kind of like to continue the line with my fingernail as best as I can. And then there goes the other part. So this is what you're left with. And then just go ahead and braid that again. I know this seems like really strange and complicated, and the first couple times I did it, it did not look good. The more you practice, the better you'll get. So just take another 1/2 inch section, add it to the frontmost part of the braid, and then take another section, again continuing that line to the back, and then add it to the backmost section of the braid, and then go ahead and braid once and you can see our little braid is starting to form. So just continue to do that, adding a little bit of hair to the outer strands as you're going along. So when you're done, when you're at the end, just take your bobby pin and go ahead and secure the braid to the rest of your hair. So now what you can do is just let your ponytail loose and flip the rest of your hair over the braid, and this is what you'll be left with. So this is a quick little trick that you can use to do a lot of different hairstyles. Like I said, this is not like a hairstyle necessarily. You can wear your hair down like this. This is how I would wear my hair when I had this braid in, only because I'm not sophisticated enough to do buns and what other stuff I could be doing. I just like my hair down most days. So this is a nice little trick that only takes typically a couple minutes to do if you're not talking and have a bunch of lights in your face. The more you practice, the better you'll get at it, because like I said in the beginning, when I first started learning how to do this, I was really terrible at it. I could not get the hang of it. I was getting so frustrated and aggravated with my hair with this trick. I was like, how come so many people can do it and I can't? But like with everything, practice makes perfect. So the more you practice, the better you'll get at it, and you will be left with something like this. I know this is not super perfect, but this is the general idea. You're gonna have basically a braid that goes down the side of your face. You can do it on both sides. You can start from even over here and work it all the way out to here. I just personally look better with my part being here because I have a cowlick on this side. So my hair doesn't really like to kind of like comb over like this. But again, everybody's different. Your hair might like to do that or might naturally do that. So just do whatever you can, whatever looks best on you. So that is it. Thank you so much for watching my video. I hope this was helpful. If you have any questions or comments or tips, then leave them down in the comment sections. I love reading comments, and other people like to see them as well, I think. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you want to see more of my videos, subscribe down below, and I will see you later. Bye.